when we came out of the giant C-19 pandemic, I really thought there was a few companies that did a good job. The Wynn Resorts was one of them. Of course, Encore and Wynn are the same company here in Las Vegas. I really thought that they were doing well, even though they put out their horrible 28-page plan to scare the hell out of you about even coming here before anything even reopened. They kind of backtracked and they did the right thing in a lot of cases. But the headline that I read in the Review Journal versus the story inside makes me wonder altogether what the heck they're even thinking. We're going to talk about that headline and about how the Wynn has gone off the deep end to the level that Caesars Entertainment did. We talked about that on the channel a few weeks ago. Look, I'm for companies making profits, but I'm not for companies making profits while people are being laid off and furloughed and not sure how the heck they're going to pay their mortgages. And that's kind of what the Wynn is doing right now. So we're going to talk about a few of the positive aspects of what the Wynn actually did. We're going to talk about some of the negative aspects and how they basically maybe lost their way entirely and none of this makes any more sense. My name is Steven, by the way. I'm not leaving Las Vegas. Like, share, subscribe the videos, leave us a comment below and tell us, what do you think about what I'm going to tell you about the Wynn? Do you love the properties? Is this going to change your opinion? What do you think about the Review Journal? Because they're also implicated in this tale of debauchery and media lies in Las Vegas. And I actually like the Review Journal and I like the Wynn. So I don't like talking about this kind of stuff. It's kind of ridiculous, don't you think? If you guys want to further support the channel, head on over to Patreon. Finishing up my Caesars property video. It's like 20 minutes long almost. Oh my God, so much editing, so many cuts. You get early access to that. You also get your name in the credits of the videos every time I do a video. We also have VegasFaceMask.com. There you go, VegasFaceMask.com. Two face masks, $25. My wife makes them right here. And you gotta wear a face mask until there's a vaccine. We gotta slow the spread. I'm not an anti-masker. I'm just a person that knows that these things probably help a little bit. And I'll try to help a little bit. All right, so that being said, the Wynn, Wynn, Wynn. What are we going to do with you guys? You guys are falling into bed with the crew over there at Caesars Entertainment, aren't you? Yeah, or you're worried about your CEOs going that way. This is the worst thing I've heard since the CEOs over at Caesars gave themselves a pay raise. This is just ridiculous. Now, the headline reads on the Review Journal from a few days ago, Wynn employees to receive stock and move to keep workers. That sounds great, doesn't it? But if you say Walmart employees to receive stock in order and move to keep workers, everybody would be like, great, yeah, those people went through the ringer. They're still working on the front lines. They were out there making sure we got our toilet paper and our water as fast as we could. Give them some stock shares. Why don't you? That's not what's happening here. No. We have greed in the nth degree over here. Let's talk about a few positive things that the Wynn did shortly right here. We'll get to what the stupid ridiculousness is in a second and why it's hard to respect the Wynn for me today when they do moves like this and why they might have actually done it. So the Wynn did reopen on June 4th. One of the great things that they did was they paid all their workers through the entire C-19 shutdown to the tune of $250 million, according to the company. So they paid 15,000 employees up to $250 million for the entire lot just to keep them out of the unemployment lines or the unemployment system, because that's terrible. People wanted to know that they had their companies got their back. That was a super positive thing. The only other person that did that in Vegas was Sheldon Adelson right next door to the Wynn. And I have a feeling that they're still competing because they competed in the past, even though Steve Wynn's no longer in the company. I have a feeling they want to keep up with the Joneses. Those are positive things. Positive things. The other things that they did that weren't so positive were, or that were positive. Let's talk about some more positives. That's fair enough. When they opened up, they tried to open up everything at their properties to give people the closest version of a full Vegas experience they could have. You know, for the first little while, I don't know if they're still doing it, there was guys at the entrances of the properties trying to take temperatures when you would go into the property. That's a good thing. Like, they're doing the right things. A couple of the big missteps that they've had, though, they're not so great. So those are the positives. Let's talk about the negatives, leading all the way up to this ridiculous story on the Review Journal. I'm going to read the headline one more time so you can see how it's really not what the Review Journal says. The Review Journal, again, said last week, Wynn employees to receive stock and move to keep workers. All right, we'll get to that lie in a minute. So a couple of missteps that they had. Well, I mean, first of all, I got a message from a friend in early July. Early July, the message said that one of their family members works at the Wynn, and they were never laid off because they were deemed essential, but even they had to take a pay cut. They told me that the pay cuts were between 5 to 20%. Everybody was sworn to not talk to the media about it, and I couldn't prove it. So it became a rumor that I thought could basically damage the image of the Wynn. And I'm like, well, why? Maybe I shouldn't say that. I could not prove it. She couldn't give me any kind of documentation. Later on, Fox 5, Las Vegas, they went and they contacted the Wynn enough that the Wynn actually said, yes, that really happened. Guess who didn't get a pay cut? I know you know the answer. It was the people that actually run the company. They didn't get a pay cut. But then again, win employees to receive stock and move to keep workers. If that's becoming hyper annoying, just bear with me here. There's a reason I keep saying that over and over again. It will all make sense in a roundabout way in just a moment. Of course, on July 22nd, they had to do some furloughs. I understand that completely. We are in the middle of the spike. The cases were getting really bad. People were not coming here. Furloughs don't mean that you lost your job. It just means that your job position is no longer available right now. It's going to be available in the future. Go home. We can't pay you. You're not losing your medical benefits. Your seniority stays intact. That's a positive thing. They weren't permanent layoffs, and that was okay. And they also said, if you have this issue, we're going to pay all your medical expenses if you're furloughed all the way to October 31st. Okay, fair enough. That's okay. Okay, cool. But then now we have now we have what it is. Win employees to receive stock and move to keep workers is the headline on the Review Journal. But that's not the case. That's not what they actually did. See, the Wynn Resorts, they did a stock offering of 176,247 stock shares. That's $15,218,928. That went to 240, wait for it, higher-ups and executives, including the CEO of the company. Yeah. So the Review Journal wrote that headline, and the Wynn actually did that thing. It was not workers. It wasn't employees. I mean, yeah, they work for the company and they are employed by the Wynn. And if you want to be very, very technical, it's kind of like, stop touching me, stop touching me. Oh, what's wrong? I'm touching you. It's like kids. It's like a childish headline. And I like the Review Journal. I really do. But this kind of stuff, I'm trying to figure out how this could happen. I think the meeting would have gone something like this. The people from the Review Journal would have seen the filing with the SEC, the Securities Exchanges Commission. All public companies have to give a filing, and they would have gone to the Wynn and they would have said, hey, we're doing an article, an expose, or a piece on how you offered, 176,000 plus shares to the 240 executives. How do we word that? Because we don't want to make you mad and lose all of our media access. The Wynn said, well, just tell them that we're giving employees some stock in order to keep the workers happy. And that's not, that's not what happened. So yeah, 240 of the upper level executives and higher ups in the company got on average $63,412 in the middle of a pandemic, in the middle of all of this falling down around us, in the middle of them possibly turning those furloughs into permanent layoffs, into permanent job losses. Who knows when those people get their jobs back? But hey, we got your back, guys. The CEO of Wynn himself had over $2 million in extra pay. Now, the way this stock offering works is simple. They give it right now, and if in a year's time, they can cash it out. So right now, it's $86 a share. This means that if it shoots up to $100 a share, that is a lot bigger of a pay raise than it would have been even if they were able to cash those stocks out today, which they totally can. This retains them for a year. This keeps them on there for a year. If they walk away from the company in the next year, they lose their option to get their bonus on the stocks that they offered out to them. And it's just a bummer deal. Now, I can imagine this might be happening right now because maybe they're worried about headhunting from companies that are desperately trying to get professionals working in their ranks. Maybe they're worried about Caesars Entertainment, the newly formed version, coming and headhunting their employees. Maybe they're worried about people over at Las Vegas Sands Corporation looking for some expertise across the street. We know Phil Ruffin is probably not looking for that because he doesn't have stocks and he doesn't want to pay anybody. He wants to use his own cash to stay liquid, according to him in a Forbes article. So let's assume that his corporate headhunting is part of it. We have to retain the workers and the employees. Give me a break. Give me a break. We all know what 99% of the population thinks of when they think of workers and employees. They're not thinking of people who on average in Las Vegas have $100,000 a year salary, okay? And workers and employees versus executives are something that we have a problem with in society. And I'm not against you becoming an executive. I hope you do someday and you get all the money that you ever need for anything and you live a happy life. But when you do things like this, this doesn't help the cause. This doesn't help your public image very much. So thanks to the Review Journal for buttering it up for us. But Wynn, what are you thinking right now? What are you thinking of doing with that? Yeah, I know you got to have the important people in place in order to run your company, but there has to be a better way. Maybe you could have offered something in the way of, some benefits to people or some extra pay increases to people who are working in the casinos right now to balance the force out on both sides. But then again, you're probably not turning a profit. That's why you're not paying them cash bonuses. That's why you're offering them a stock option that comes to maturation in a year. Anyhow, I just thought I would show you that. That's the tale of how the Wynn did some good stuff in Las Vegas, but how at the very end, they had to furlough some people. And then that's the way that our media will spin things for you too. Drives me absolutely crazy. I can't stand it. I have to be true to myself. I'm really sorry. Some people have been saying lately I seem high and righteous on a high horse, but I'm starting to see the news in a different way. I'm starting to see it in a different light. Not a super negative light. The city is going to come back. The city's going to be fantastic and wonderful, as Arnold would say. Fantastic and wonderful. I only do the Arnold voice on my live stream. But this stuff right here, this is ridiculous. This has to be a better way to do this. I'm sorry, guys. That's what it is. But that's the video for today. You tell me in the comments below what you really think about how the Wynn Resorts is conducting itself right now. If you guys want to support the channel, reach on over to Patreon. I got to go to update those credits right now for all the new patrons we've had. And I thank you guys so much for your support. There is VegasFaceMask.com. The only two you'll ever need. Put mine up right here. Two for 25 bucks. The wife does those. We appreciate the support, and thank you guys for considering Vegas for a future vacation. Even though the CEOs of these companies do some silly things, we still have a great city for you guys to come to when it's safe for you. Like, share, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications. I gotta say 3, 2, 1, click. 3, 2, 1, and click. Thank you.